Hey, what is up, everybody of the TFW Stockyards Familia, core members and 6-week challengers alike. Again, apologize for my voice. Coaching the 5 a.m.s has been a doozy for my vocal cords, but that's not the point of this live. The point of this live is a message that we touched on at the very beginning of this week, talking about the big picture. Right? Talking about how it's easy for us as human beings, as we're in our fitness journey or in any area of our life, to major in the minor stuff, right? And so today I want to reel you guys back in because it's my job as your health and fitness coach to get you healthier, right? To get you to hit your goals. And I think it's easy to lose sight because you're always looking for, you know, what's another way to do something, or you get caught up in all the information that's out there, right? Like, what's the best supplement? What's the best protein powder? What's the best multivitamin, coach? Hey, you know, what has more grams of carbohydrates, right? Brown rice or white rice, right? Should I be eating quinoa because it has less calories, right? So I want to give you guys 7 things, right? 7 things to focus on as your big picture. If you can nail down these 7 things, meaning put all of your time and energy into these 7 areas, you will hit goal. You will look and feel amazing, guaranteed, but you got to do it 7 days a week, right? These 7 things you do every single day, right? So the whole week, this is your focus, right? Now, these are in no particular order, but these are the things that you need to be doing, right? So the first one right here, meal prepping, right? So that means you need to pick a day of the week and stay consistent. Saturday or Sunday, you are creating a meal plan for the week, breakfast, lunch, dinner, right? What are, you know, the kiddos eating? What is mom and dad eating? Cool. You know exactly what to go get because you know what you're having for all the meals and snacks of the week. You create your grocery shopping list off that, and then you go shopping, and then you meal prep, right? The next thing is mealtime consistency, right? Like, I know some days, like maybe you work a night shift, the next day you work a morning shift, but what you need to be doing, right? And yeah, you're gonna have to carry food with you. You're gonna have to carry snacks with you, right? Again, it comes down to how bad do you want to change, right? And so breakfast needs to be at a certain time. Lunch needs to be at a certain time. Dinner needs to be at a certain time, right? So your body, right, hormones, neurotransmitters, all that good stuff, operates on a circadian rhythm. If you're skipping meals and sporadically eating, you will have a hell of a time losing body fat and building muscle tissue, and i.e. getting to where you want to go health and fitness wise. So you're going to be prepping your meals every single week. You're going to be eating the meals at the same time every single week, right? Training at the dojo. Guys, like, ideally, what I recommend is 5 hours of exercise a week. Now, I'm not saying you gotta be in the dojo 5 days a week. If you can, that's even better. But if you're gonna come 3, then you need to be active for another 2 hours outside the dojo. If you come 4, 1 hour. If you come 5, you hit your quota, right? But once again, guys, you have to have sufficient stimuli to build muscle and create a caloric deficit, right, to lose weight, right? So you got meal prepping, right? You got mealtime consistency. 7 days a week, you're eating the same meals, or meal time, right? Not the same meals. Then you got your being in the dojo at least 4 days a week so you can get stronger physically and mentally, burn body fat, right? And then, hey, number five, you're drinking mostly water, right? 96 to 138 ounces a day, right? If you are just not a big water drinker, a good strategy is every time you go to drink, right? Let's do this, right? Okay. You're going to take 10 big gulps. 1, 2, 3. So if you're only touching water to your face like 5 or 6 times a day, you're drinking a lot of water. So you're not just sipping on it and setting it down, all right? So the 5th thing you're focusing on, guys, is drinking this amount of water every single day, okay? Hey, number 6, right? It's a big one, 7 to 8 hours of sleep. Right. If you think that you cannot get that, then you need to be taking a time inventory of your week. Write down on a sheet of paper everything you do, like from hour to hour. And you'll see that there's 15 minutes here, 10 minutes here, 30 minutes there. That are what I would call time vampires that are sucking your day away, that are keeping you from achieving 7 to 8 hours of sleep. Right. I wrote a blog about how to strategize on getting more sleep, but why sleep is so essential to a healthy life, right? So if you are chronically undersleeping, man, you are missing out on some serious, serious potential progress, right? And then last but not least, guys, stress management, right? Everybody's overstressed. If you live in North America and you're a working parent, you are overstressed right now, okay? And so you need strategies, like tactics, ways to manage your stress, right? Whether that's, you know, in the morning, you have quiet time with yourself, maybe you're spiritual, so you read a Bible, maybe you pray, maybe you do mindful practices of yoga, deep breathing techniques, right? If all that is too esoteric or metaphysical for you, right, then find a book that you enjoy. Make sure you read it, right? Watch a funny movie. You got to figure out what makes you happy and be doing that a couple times a week, right? Because all that, guys, all seven of these steps play into you living a healthier life, okay? So if you have any feedback, any comments, any questions, drop them in there below. Talk to you all soon.